Hi. There was a recent post today showing how to make a curved ramp using the slab objects in PyroSim. And that's a nice way to do it if you'd like to stay in PyroSim and use the slab tool and manipulate all the vertices to make a complex shape like a ramp. There are other methods that may be a little bit easier or faster depending on your background. You could use 3D CAD modeling tools. I'll be using SketchUp just to show you as an example of using a free tool to create the geometry that you can then import into PyroSim. So we'll be using the same ramp set. It's a 5-unit by 5-unit base platform and a 5 by 5 unit top platform. We'll have a radius of 5 units on the inside diameter here, or the inside radius of the curve of the ramp, and it'll ramp up in this direction. Before I go too far in SketchUp, I just want to mention I'm using a nice extension called Upright Extrude. You can get to that through the extension warehouse. You can find it, just type in Upright Extrude, and you can also install that through your extension manager once you've downloaded that to your computer. So once you've installed that extension, you'll have a little toolbar, and we'll just be using this button right here. So first we'll get rid of our little mannequin there. And then here's how we'll create the base geometry to create our curved ramp. So I'll be using a 3-point arc where I set the center point. I'll come out in along the red axis, tap the number 5 on my keyboard, and enter to create this point of the arc. And then I'll just come around 90 degrees to create a quarter circle. So there's the inside radius of my arc. Now I want sort of a nice transition in and out of the ramp. To the top and bottom platform. So the first thing I'll do is just starting here, and I'll move in the red axis direction, and let's go 0.5 meters or 0.5 units there. And then from this point in the green axis direction, 0.5 meters. So that gives me kind of an connection in and out of this curved ramp surface. This also gives me a nice little handle here from doing the next transformation, which is to take this little, select this little handle, and using the move tool, I'll find the midpoint of this. Doesn't really matter what point, but I'll just use the midpoint. And if I start moving it, you can see it's really kind of distorting the shape. If I hit the up arrow on my keyboard, it locks now to the blue axis, which is in the Z direction. So as I move up now, I'm just moving in the vertical direction. I can then hit 3 on my keyboard and enter to go up in the Z direction 3 units. So that's my transition from the lower level to the upper level. Let's roll this around a little bit. You can kind of see that shape going in that direction. So then finally, we want to make our lower platform that transitions up to the upper platform. And so we've already moved a half a unit in this direction. So I'll just use the same corner point here to create the thickness, sort of the slab for my platform. It's trying to default to the sort of this horizontal plane. If I hit the right arrow key, it snaps to constrain this shape to the red plane in this direction, which is sort of perpendicular to the x direction, x axis. So as I start to move here, I can then just type in what I want. So I know I want it 5 wide, and let's say we make it 0.3 units thick. So if I do 5, 0.3, enter, I get that shape that I want. And now I'm going to extrude this. Do that upright extrude to this shape along this path. So if I pick the face that I want, and then I'll select the curve that I want, and then I just click this little tool, and it creates that extruded ramp for me that goes up the level. So I did extend back already a half of a unit in this direction, so I need to pull this back 4.5 more. So we'll get the extrude face, click on this face, and then just type in 4.5 and enter. So there's that side to give me 5, and then same thing over here. Click here, start back, 4.5, enter, and now we have the extruded ramp with nice even transitions on and off of the ramp. So now we will export this to a 3D model. We'll call this ramp. And I already have one of those, so sure, we'll replace it. And now let's go into PyroSim, and we will import that CAD. So let's go find ramp.dae, which is the file that I just made. And we don't know if you use SimLab, it's just a little different, but we'll say unknown. And all we have to do here is just next, 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 and finish. And now we have the nice ramp in PyroSim. So there's our geometry. So now you'll see that there's the model object here, and there's this little SketchUp shape to it. Let's go ahead and realign this. So if I go to the 2D view top view, we'll see that the axis lines are kind of out where that center point of the radius was, because I use that as that origin point. I'd like to shift this whole ramp so that this corner is at the origin. So once we have that object selected like that, I can just click here and move this. So anytime you import CAD, you can just move it into position after you've imported it in PyroSim. Let's go back to 3D view, just sort of zoom everything here and roll around. So I have this in position. Let's make a mesh now. So a new mesh, mesh one, and OK. And we'll preview the object against the mesh. And there we go. So we have our ramp rasterized with the mesh. You'll notice this is a pretty good transformation. If you notice any thin obstructions, everything looks fairly thick here in this. Sometimes thin obstructions can lead to some issues. Depends on how thick your sort of slab is or the thickness of your ramp, and if that snaps down to a thin obstruction or not. But if it is making thin obstructions and you'd like to just thicken that up a bit, you can always go into the object and click Thicken, and you'll see that just sort of thicken out and make sure it everything fills at least one grid cell. In the model. So all of your geometry will fit one grid cell as a minimum. So we have that now. But as you can see, it's not the best for this particular model. We made a nice thick slab, so we really don't need that, and we get a nice shape to it. The beauty of this, using this method, is that unlike working in PyroSim, we have fairly simplistic tools that you can use, and you can use slabs to manipulate vertices and try to create shapes with it. That works nicely for like roof decking, roof surfaces, pitches, things like that as well. In CAD, you can create, I could make a spiral and extrude up through the spiral. I can make a lot of shapes using a lot of these tools that are really easy to use for modeling all kinds of polygons and circles and arcs and freehand tools and freehand shapes and everything. I could even, instead of going around a curve like this, I could draw a freehand shape in space, have a path follow the freehand shape, and then import that into PyroSim. So this gives you a lot more flexibility in terms of what you can draw and how it works. So if you have any questions, please let us know. Hopefully you find this helpful. And both methods, if you'd like to stay in PyroSim, it's great. Great tutorial there with the slabs. If you're comfortable in a CAD tool and you can export any of our supported formats, DAE, OBJ, FBX, DWG, DXF, any of those, you can bring those right into PyroSim and then work with that geometry there.